Good evening. My name is Kacper Paradowski and you're watching Poland Daily News. Everything indicates that the conflict between the United States and Iran is far behind us, despite the fact that Donald Trump and Iranian leaders still have animosity towards each other. It seems that neither Washington nor Tehran are interested in escalating the situation.
As long as I'm president of the United States, Iran will never be allowed to have a nuclear weapon.
By this statement, Donald Trump started his declaration in which he gave a further statement on Iran's attack on the American military bases stationed in Iraq. The attack was Iran's revenge on the United States for killing General Qasem Soleimani. President Trump has announced to put sanctions on Iran for the organized attacks.
As we continue to evaluate options in response to Iranian aggression, the United States will immediately impose additional punishing economic sanctions on the Iranian regime. Our missiles are big, powerful, accurate, lethal, and fast. Under construction are many hypersonic missiles. The fact that we have this great military and equipment, however, does not mean we have to use it. We do not want to use it.
In his speech, Donald Trump turned not only to Iran, but also to the European leaders, as well as China and Russia, to help resolve this conflict.
Iran must abandon its nuclear ambitions and end its support for terrorism. The time has come for the United Kingdom, Germany, France, Russia, and China to recognize this reality. They must now break away from the remnants of the Iran deal, or JCPOA. And we must all work together toward making a deal with Iran that makes the world a safer and more peaceful place.
China ensures that they cooperate with Russia in order to keep balance in the region. Pope Francis engaged in the conflict by appealing for dialogue.
The signals coming from the entire region are very worrying because the rising tension between the US and Iran can not only make the reconstruction of Iran impossible, but also it can lead to a gigantic conflict, which all of us want to avoid. That is why I would like to repeat my appeal to both sides of the conflict, establish a dialogue.
Today, the commander of the Iranian Revolutionary Guard, Abdullah Araghchi, announced Iran's revenge on the United States.
At the invitation of the Speaker of the Senate, Tomasz Grodzki, a delegation of the Venice Commission came to Poland. The delegation, which acts as an advisory body to the Council of Europe, is to review the amendment to the Act on the changes in the system of common courts, currently underway in the Senate.
The meeting between Speaker of the Senate, Tomasz Grodzki, and the representatives of the Venice Commission lasted 1 hour. The talks regarded the amendment to the judiciary legislation, which has already been accepted by the lower house of the parliament and is underway in the Senate. The Senate is doing what the Sejm did not do. We are speaking about and analyzing the amendment. I think the Commission's opinion will be ready in a week. The opposition hopes that the Venice Commission's audit could stop the politicization of the judicial system, which, in their opinion, is what the ruling party is trying to achieve. Law and Justice deputies would rather destroy something before repairing it. I believe that before you break something, you should first consider making changes. This is what should happen here. This legislation is very bad, it should be improved, hence the meeting with the Venice Commission. The head of the Parliamentary Justice Commission, Marek Ast, believes that the visit of the Venice Commission is unnecessary. The fact that it is taking place now, when the amendment is being processed by the Senate, raises doubts. This creates a real danger that the Senate will simply assume the remarks made by the Venice Commission. This shows how great of an influence the EU organs have on the work of the Senate.
projektu, który w tej chwili jest procedowany w Senacie.
Tomorrow, the Venice Commission representatives will meet with the first president of the Supreme Court, Małgorzata Gersdorf, as well as the Polish ombudsman, Adam Bodnar. The opinion of the Venice Commission is to be revealed next week, on Wednesday or Thursday, which would coincide with the planned Senate sitting, scheduled to take place between the 15th and 17th of January. Unofficially, the Senate will process the judicial legislation on January 17th.
Two gas transmission pipeline operator companies, Gaz System and Europipe, have signed a contract in Warsaw for the supply of special tubing for the offshore segment of the Baltic Pipe gas pipeline. The gas pipeline, which is to be put into operation in autumn 2022, will connect the Polish and Danish gas systems, which will allow the transmission of 10 billion cubic meters of gas from the Norwegian shelf to Poland.
The project is on the finishing stages of securing licenses and permits for the construction of the infrastructure. The competitive bidding process to build the underwater and ground segments of the Baltic Pipe project is underway. The preparation stages will be finished in the first half of this year, after which we'll begin the construction of the underwater part of the pipeline.
27 people have been killed and over 2,000 houses were burnt down in catastrophic fires that Australia has been struggling with for months. According to meteorologists, the temperatures will rise again on Friday, which will make the fight against the fire even harder to win.
Rebuild, and I'm very pleased that the Treasurer and I are today announcing a $1 billion boost to support all of our communities in impacted areas. This is to rebuild communities, this is to focus on infrastructure that's either been damaged, destroyed or needs improving, and it's to ensure that communities can have confidence in rebuilding.
I have just extended the state of disaster for another 48 hours, so it will run until just before midnight on Saturday evening. The reason I've done that is that we have forecast conditions of extreme danger. Very significant fire activity is likely off the back of a hot day today, a hot day tomorrow, and a change not coming through in the east of the state till late afternoon tomorrow, and in the northern part of the state not until the evening on Saturday. This means that we have every reason to believe there will be significant fire activity over the next 48 hours.
That is all for tonight. Thank you for watching. Stay with us for Poland Daily Business. Good night.